Welcome back. Every artist is looking for one thing, a steady paycheck. Or maybe their next great song.
First one was true. And that's where the show Songland comes in. This is so cool. Each week, unknown writers pitch their songs to major recording artists, and the winner gets a chance to have their music recorded and released worldwide.
I mean, was this just made for Nashville or
Amen.
What?
Hello.
But look at that guy right there. We have one of the producers from the show. He's with us this morning. Shane McAnally. He's multiple Grammy Award winning songwriter. You've had 38 number ones.
I mean, at 40 now. It's true.
Listen,
but
I
who's
joke.
Counting?
You are.
So I joke. Listen, you count everyone.
I joke. So much. I said, this so is good. Shane McAnally's life. He drives down Music Row in a convertible and people throw awards into
it's
the
true.
Back seat.
I do love trophies.
You like trophies, but you definitely deserve all of them. Thank I remember you told us about this being in development. And
yeah.
you said, okay, there's this really cool concept. What was it about Songland that made you really want to be a part of it?
Well, it is what I do every day.
Right.
Is I have the opportunity to work with songwriters that aren't, you know, in the flow yet, that haven't had that break. I was here for 14 years before I ever had a song recorded. Mm-hmm. But I still work with a lot of new songwriters. And, you know, just giving them your experience, you can't really judge a song because it's all, what's the word, like subjective?
So subjective,
yeah,
sure.
exactly.
It
your
is.
Story
Absolutely.
May not, I may not relate to it, so I can't really say your song is not good. But what I can give experience on is how to take your song and make it something that someone would record, a big artist.
Because that's really what people are looking for.
And that's what the show is about.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you will hear a song on the show, and you're going to kind of give them your coach. You're coaching them up. You're saying, let's tweak it. Let's do a little something, yes?
Yeah, so basically people pitch the songs to myself, Ryan Tedder, and Esther Dean. We're the mentors. And then every week we have a big hit artist. Tonight it's Kelsey Ballerini. We've had John Legend. We've seen Will.i.am record his, you know, big hit that just came out called Be Nice. And these are songs that they found on the show.
That's
and
amazing.
they come out with the show. At the end, you see the finished product from where it started, and you see the sort of evolution of the whole songwriting process.
I gotta ask though, being a songwriter, first and foremost, you've got to feel so much empathy for these people walking into the room, performing a song for you and Ryan Tedder and Esther and Kelsey.
And then you put, and Macklemore and Jonas Brothers. I've said that so many times to people. I'm like, there's one part of this that I feel like, God, y'all are getting such a huge opportunity. They're leapfrogging over A&R, publishing, producers. They're going straight to the artist.
Truly.
I said, but if I had had to sit in front of Kenny Chesney and go, here's my song, will you record it? I don't think I could have done it because that is so personal, especially when no one's heard the song.
Right.
That just adds this whole, you know, if a song's a hit, you play it in front of people and they're like, well, yeah, it must be good, it's on the radio.
Play Body Like a Back Road, everybody's loving it.
Exactly. Thanks. That's, you know, it's a personal story about my body.
It is.
But it started out Body Like a Pothole, but we worked on it.
We're like, that's not working.
Oh my gosh, this comedian at the roast that they did of me, he said, he goes, so you wrote Body Like a Back Road. That's not a compliment. I thought that was hilarious. But anyway, so, you know, when they're playing a song that's so personal, but no one knows it, that is the most vulnerable
Absolutely.
You can be.
I think what's so exciting about the show is that, like you said, the song is happening.
Right.
It's going to happen. I think a lot of the shows that come out, it's like, will this singer really carry on after this,
but this
segment?
This is about the life of a song.
I mean, that's incredible to me.
And they get it. I mean, instantly the win is that a huge artist records one of these songs, and that's a copyright. You own the publishing for the rest of your life. So, you know, John Legend recorded a song that I worked on with Tebby Burrows, who was one of the contestants. Now she has a song that John Legend has put into the world on all streaming services. You can buy it anywhere, and that will last forever.
Okay, can I just get my name on one of these songs
so I can
get a paycheck?
I've been trying for 18 years. It hasn't happened for me. Question, are you keeping score which ones that you win? I know you are.
Well, here's the thing.
You're winning. You're winning.
You know,
right now,
it really isn't supposed to be a competition between the three of us.
Whatever.
Of course, Ryan Tedder, if you've ever met him, he's competitive. I can't help but look over my shoulder and see what he's doing.
He's keeping score, and so are we. Guys, you've got to see it, Songland, every Tuesday night, 9 o'clock, right here on News 4. Such a good time. Thank you so much.
We love you.
I love you.
We'll be back
tonight.
Bye. You're the best.
Well, that was terrible.
You're totally winning.